वेलकम टू अल्टीमेट बायोलॉजी। टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट दिस एपोमिक्सिस एंड पॉली एम्ब्रियोनी। दिस वन इज द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन केस ऑफ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट। एपोमिक्सिस एंड पॉली एम्ब्रियोनी, सी हियर, एपोमिक्सिस और अगैमोस्पर्मी मीन्स दीज अ टू टॉपिक्स आर देयर। वन इज द एपोमिक्सिस एंड सेकेंड वन इज द पॉली एम्ब्रियोनी, आउट ऑफ विच इन नेक्स्ट स्लाइड वी आर गोइंग टू सी दिस ओनली वन टॉपिक, दैट इज एपोमिक्सिस, देन वी विल सी पॉली एम्ब्रियोनी। एपोमिक्सिस ऑल्सो नोन एज अगैमोस्पर्मी। हियर दिस एपोमिक्सिस डिफाइन एज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सीड विदाउट एक्ट ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन, नोन एज एपोमिक्सिस। मीन्स हियर एज पर रूल सीड फॉर्मेशन टेक्स प्लेस और फ्रूट फॉर्मेशन टेक्स प्लेस। दिस प्रोसेस टेक्स प्लेस आफ्टर फर्टिलाइजेशन। आफ्टर फर्टिलाइजेशन ओव्यूल कन्वर्ट इन टू सीड एंड आफ्टर फर्टिलाइजेशन दैट ओवरी वॉल इट गेट कन्वर्ट इन टू फ्रूट वॉल, दैट इज अ रूल। बट हियर इन केस ऑफ दिस एपोमिक्सिस फॉर्मेशन ऑफ दैट सीड फ्रॉम द ओव्यूल टेक्स प्लेस विदाउट एक्ट ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन। Means fertilization do not takes place in apomixis without act of fertilization. Seed formation takes place. We call it as apomixis. Here apo means, here apo means without. Mixis means mixing. Means without mixing of these male and female gamete. Seed formation takes place from the ovule. We call it as apomixis, or we call it as agamospermy. Agamo means gamete do not fuse. Agamo, and here spermy, sperma means seed. Formation of a seed without act of fertilization. We call it as apomixis or agamospermy. Next, according to these, hence these Winkler, they define apomixis as replacement of the normal sexual reproduction by asexual reproduction. Means without fertilization, asexually, like these plant they produce, these plant they produce like these seed. For example, in case of these Poe bulbosa, second that is this one, this plant, Caribbean agave, and third one, this one common, we call it as a citrus. Seed formation takes place here asexually, means a sexual act do not takes place here. Means here fertilization do not takes place. Without fertilization, seed formation takes place in case of this example. So these Hans Winkler define apomixis or this agamospermy as replacement of the normal sexual reproduction by asexual reproduction, known as apomixis or agamospermy. Or it is also defined as apomixis is a form of asexual reproduction that mimics sexual reproduction. Means sexual reproduction do not take place, but still without act of this fertilization, seed formation is there. Means it mimic knuckle, it mimic as a sexual reproductive that structure without meiosis and syngamy, called apomixis or agamospermy, differentiated into these two type. One is the agamospermy and second one is the vegetative propagation. This agamospermy or these the apomixes get defined by the scientist. Vegetative propagation, it is a type of a reproduction in which that plant it reproduce asexually. Means there are some individuals, they do not accept that vegetative propagation is apomixis. But they accept that by vegetative propagation, by these method, plant they reproduce. What it may be? These agamospermie again differentiated into like these three types. One is the diplospory, second one is the apospory, and third one is the these parthenogenesis. Diplospory takes place by mitosis cell division in that embryo sac. And this is again are of three type. One is the pterygium, second type that is a xeris, and third type that is a antenaria. Then apospory. This is the apospory that is a development of diploid gametophyte without meiosis and spore formation and embryo formation from vegetative or non-reproductive cell takes place in case of this apospory. And third one is the parthenogenesis, that is the formation of embryo from unfertilized egg. We call it as a parthenogenesis. We will see these all three type details in next slide. Next, that is the etymology, means away from mixing, we call it as etymology. Here offspring which is formed, that is genetically identical to the parents, because it is a asexual type of reproduction. It reproduces by vegetative cells, due to which the genetic makeup of that offspring, that individual, new individual, is the same as it is as their parent in case of this apomixis or this apomictic seed. So this one agamospermie type, diplospory, apospory, and is a parthenogenesis, we will see detail in next slide. Now we will see three type of that apomixis. One diplospory, second one is the apospory, and third one that is a parthenogenesis. Now generally in majority of angiospermic plant, they adopt sexual reproduction process. In sexual reproduction process, that we have seen all these sexual reproduction process in previous videos. In sexual reproduction process, plant produce like this haploid gamete, that is egg. This one, this is the structure, we call it as a gynoecium, which is the innermost whorl of the flower, and it consists of this one stigma, then second this one style, and this portion we call it as ohuri. Inside ohuri, this is the structure, we call it as ohul. And in the ohul, by the process of this gametogenesis process, like this egg formation takes place. In the ohul, the first cell from which this egg formation takes place, that cell is a diploid in nature, 2n like this. Diploid in nature, but in this cell, meiosis cell division takes place. Meiosis is the reductional cell division in which the chromosome number reduced to half. Means from one cell, when the two cell formation takes place by meiosis cell division, here the two cell which is formed, that is these two cells are haploid in nature, means consist of half chromosome, means they are only haploid in nature, consist of n type of what, that chromosome. And then from these two cell, four cell formation takes place, they are also haploid in nature, and out of these four, these that megaspore upper three degenerate and only one remain a functional, and from these a functional megaspore in which one haploid nucleus which is there, this nucleus undergoes free nuclear division. Means here first a meiosis cell division takes place, that is a meiosis, and then from here free nuclear division takes place. One nucleus divided into two, which is haploid in nature, then again two nucleus divided into four, into eight, and out of these eight nucleus, four nucleus move towards the one end, we call it as a chalazal end, and four nucleus move towards the one end, we call it as a micropylar end. Out of that four nucleus, one nucleus from one pole move in the center, and from chalazal end, one nucleus move in the center, and here these are two polar nuclei formation is there. Then embryo sac formation takes place like this. Towards the chalazal end, 1, 2, 3 antipodal cell formation takes place after cell wall formation. And towards this, a micropylar end, this one functional egg cell formation is there, which is surrounds with these are two supportive cell. We call it as a synergid. This one is the egg apparatus, and these are two nuclei. We call it as a polar nuclei. And this is a sac. We call it as what? Embryo sac. This one is the egg apparatus like this, and these are the polar nuclei. Now when the pollen tube formation takes place, this is a pollen tube carry two male gamete. Pollen tube enters through these micropyle, enter in one of the synergids like this, and these are two male gamete release here. When these pollen tube burst, two male gamete release in these big cell. Out of these two male gamete, one male gamete fuses with the egg, that is we call it as a syngeny, and one male gamete fuses with these nuclei with, and here triple fusion means here one first fertilization takes place with the egg, that is a syngamy, and second fertilization takes place with the polar nuclei. Double fertilization and triple fusion phenomena takes place after that. These ovule which is there, this ovule, it get converted into seed, and this ovary wall, it get converted into this fruit. In case of angiospermic plant, after fertilization, ovule get converted into seed, and this after seed formation, then this fruit wall get ripened or fruit formation is there. But in case of apomixis, without act of fertilization, seed formation is there. This process do not take place in case of apomixis. Without act of fertilization, if a seed formation takes place, we call it as apomixis, and apomixis are of three types. One, we call it as a diplospory. And in case of this diplospory, see here, the cell which is present in the ovule, It is a diploid in nature. In case of these sexual as well as in case of these diplospory, both. First cell from which these gametogenesis process get a start, it is a diploid in nature, no doubt. But here, in case of the sexually reproducing these mechanism, these cell undergoes in meiosis cell division. But in case of apomixis, these cell undergoes in mitosis cell division, not in meiosis cell division. Mitosis is the equationary cell division in which the chromosome number remains as it is. It do not reduce to half. It remains as it is. Means here 2n number of chromosomes are there. When these cell divide into two cells, it divide mitotically, not meiotically, due to which again 2n number of chromosome remains as it is. Means a diploid, here haploid, but here diploid like these nucleus formation takes place. Diploid chromosomes are present here in these two cell. Out of these two cell, one cell degenerates and one cell remain functional, and in these functional cell here, now the nucleus, this nucleus is a diploid in nature. And now in this functional cell, free nuclear division takes place like this. Here in this cell, first a diploid cell, meiosis cell division takes place, due to which here the nucleus which is there, that nucleus is haploid in nature. Here, in these diploid cell, mitosis cell division takes place, due to which the cell which is formed, that cells are diploid in nature, and the nucleus is also diploid in nature, and these nucleus divide. Yeah, means only free nuclear division takes place here. Here only free nuclear division takes place. One nucleus divided into two nucleus divided into four into eight nucleus. All these nucleus are diploid in nature. Diploid in nature like this. And ultimately like this, embryo sac formation takes place, in which like these three antipodal cells, like these three antipodal cell formation takes place. These three antipodal cells are diploid in nature. Here it is haploid in nature. But in case of these diplospori, these antipodal cells are diploid in nature. These polar nuclei also diploid in nature. And these egg nucleus, this one, is diploid in nature. In case of diplospori, which is a type of what? Apomixis. And generally in case of that angiospermic plant, this egg is haploid in nature. This egg haploid, and these male gamete haploid, they fertilize to form a diploid. But here the egg which is formed, that egg itself is a diploid in nature, because this egg formation takes place, it is due to this mitosis cell division, and a free nuclear division get followed here. Means all these cells are diploid in nature, all the nucleus which are present here, they are diploid in nature. And when by chance if a fertilization process is going on, if the pollen tube enters one of the synergids, two male gamete release here. Out of these two male gametes, such type of the fertilization do not take place in majority of these grasses. But still, if there are some examples, what happened, see here. Out of these two male gamete, one male gamete fuses here. Means one nucleus 2N, second nucleus 2N, and this one nucleus which is haploid in nature, it consists of N. Means ultimately 5N, that is a biparental type of like these mechanism takes place here. And the second nucleus, they do not, this is the second male gamete, it do not fertilize this egg. This is the second male gamete which is there, this is the second male gamete, it dissolve. Only one male gamete fuses with the endosperm. And 5N type of endosperm formation takes place in case of what? That a grasses. Here, this egg which is there, this egg itself diploid in nature, and second male gamete which is there, that second male gamete, it get dissolved, due to which this egg, it remain as it is. Only maternal, means a maternal type of this egg remains as it is in case of this diplospori. And ultimately, without act of fertilization, here only that one male gamete fuses here, but the second male gamete, means here seeing gamete, do not take place. Without act of fertilization, from these diploid, this egg, embryo formation takes place in case of what? These diplospori, and ultimately it resulted into the ovule get converted into what? Seed. Means without act of fertilization, if a seed formation is there, by this process we call it as a diplospori. In another example, there is no pollination, there is no fertilization, means fertilization do not take place. Then these are 2N and these are 2N, 2N and these are 2N. It is a maternal only. It is a maternal only. In second type of these are diplospori, these are 2N and 2N, it forms a 4N type of endosperm. And from these unfertilized, these are diploid egg, embryo formation takes place, both maternal. It remains as it is in that majority of that grasses. They show the apomixis type of what? Seed formation. Means without act of fertilization, like this, by this mitosis cell division, and by this free nuclear, this division, the embryo sac formation takes place. And here, by this method maternal, means there is no that second means gamete comes here, only by these diploid these nuclei, 4N endosperm formation takes place, and from this diploid egg, embryo formation takes place. We call it as what? Diplospori, like this. So first type of that apomixis, that is the diplospori. Second type of that apomixis, we call it as apospori. This one, apospori. development of a diploid gametophyte without a meiosis and spore formation. Again, here there is no meiosis cell division. That one cell divided into two cell by mitosis cell division. Like this is a diploid, this is a four cell formation takes place here. And these all are formed by mitosis cell division, though embryo formation takes place or seed formation takes place, or this is the embryo sac formation takes place from non-reproductive cell, not from this cell. Not from this cell, embryo sac formation takes place. The embryo sac formation takes place from this cell, which are non-reproductive cell. This one, which is present here in the nucleus or elsewhere like this. From that cell, which is a diploid in nature, embryo sac formation takes place. This cell, non-reproductive cell, not this cell, non-reproductive cell, this one, this is a cell, nucleus, divide and redivide, means here free nuclear division takes place, one nuclei divided into 2 into 4 into 8 like this, and all nucleus they are diploid in nature, all nucleus they are diploid in nature like this, and here 4N endosperm formation takes place. And this one diploid, from this a diploid egg, embryo formation takes place, and without act of fertilization, seed formation takes place. That is the second type of what? Apomixis or a gamospermy. We call it as the apospore. And third type of, we call it as a parthenogenesis. Here parthenogenesis, without, partheno means without. Without act of fertilization, genesis, these from these diploid egg, embryo formation takes place, then we call it as what? Parthenogenesis. Without act of fertilization from the egg, embryo formation takes place. We call it as a parthenogenesis. It may be haploid in some cases and it may be diploid in some cases, in case of these apomixis. So next we will see here, these are polyembryony. These are next topic, that topic we call it as a polyembryony. And now see here what happens in case of these are polyembryony. See here, poly means many, embryony, embryo, many embryo formation takes place in that seed. When the seed germinates, many embryo formation takes place. Not one, as per rule, only one embryo come out, plumules and radical. But in case of these polyembryonic conditions, more than two embryo formation takes place in one seed, or more than two embryo get developed from one seed, we call it as a polyembryony. What is it? Polyembryony. It defined as the development of two or more embryo from single fertilized egg. More than two, one, two, three like this. More than two, one, two like this. More than two, one, two, three like this. More than two or two, that we call it as embryo formation takes place. That process we call it as a polyembryony. And it takes place in case of these citrus. It takes place in case of these mango, and it takes place in case of these maize. In case of plant, polyembryonic process is there. In case of animal also, polyembryonic process is also there. In case of human also, the identical twins or the fraternal twins which are formed. In case of a female, see here, in case of a human, what happened here? This one is the female reproductive system, and that this OHA or this secondary oocyte get a release on the 14th day of that menstrual cycle, and it wait here for the process of fertilization, and when sperm come here, it get fertilized with the sperm. After fertilization, zygote formation is there, and when this zygote divide into two cell, when there is a zygote divided into like this a two cell, by chance from this one cell and from this another cell, from this one cell embryo formation takes place and from this another cell embryo formation takes place, and like this a two twins formation takes place in case of what, a human. That is also a example of what, a polyembryony. In case of animal, cattle, polyembryony, that process takes place. So here, in case of a polyembryony, development of two or more embryo from a single fertilized egg, we call it as a polyembryony. Then next, that is the adventive embryony, that embryo formation takes place from nucellus or from the integument that deployed cell along with the egg. Takes place, for example, in case of this citrus, that type we call it as adventitive embryony. In case of this citrus, more like this embryo formation takes place from nucellus, means a nucellar tissue that they take part, that a nucellar tissue which is a nutritive in nature, that a nucellar tissue which is a diploid in nature, from that nucellar tissue some tissue they behave as a embryo, and many embryo formation takes place from this nucellar tissue. Some integumental cells or the tissue also take part in the formation of embryo. In case of a citrus, we call it as adventitive embryo. Means in case of a citrus, embryo formation takes place from these fertilized egg, as well as embryo formation takes place from nucellus as well as from the integument. In case of these citrus, in case of these mango, like these many embryo formation takes place. In case of these, like these many embryo formation takes place. Now here, these terms are there. When we call it as apomixis, or these we call it as a gamospermy, and this term is there, that is automixis or autogamy. Apomixis, automixis, a gamospermy, autogamy, like this. Means this apomixis and automixis, it creates some confusion like this. To solve this confusion, see here, apomixis, this apo means without mixing, or a gamospermy means a gamete do not fertilize, and formation of seed means it is concerned with the seed. This one apomixis or a gamospermy, it is concerned with the seed. And this automixis, here auto means self, automixis self mix, or autogamy, the gamete self gamete, means it is concerned with the pollination. Apomixis, without act of fertilization, if a seed formation is there, we call it as apomixis. And this automixis or autogamy means a transfer of pollen grain from mature anther lobe. Transfer of pollen grain from this mature anther lobe to the receptive stigma of the same flower. To the receptive stigma of what? Same flower. We call it as autogamy. Transfer of pollen grain from mature anther lobe to the receptive stigma of same flower, we call it as autogamy or automixis. And apomixis means formation of a seed without act of fertilization, we call it as apomixis. It resulted into seed and it resulted into the pollination. So these are two terms are somewhat confusing. Now next term, see here. One, parthenocarpi. Second, parthenogenesis, and third one, polyembryony. Here partheno, without act, partheno. Carpi, carpi, that is a carpe. This one is the carpe. Gynoecium, this one we call it as a carpe. This one, innermost roll of the flower, that is a gynoecium, that is a carpe. Pistil, without act of fertilization, if a fruit formation is there, without act of fertilization, carpi related with the carpel. Without act of fertilization, if fruit formation is there, we call it as a parthenocarpy. It is concerned with the seedless fruit. Here fruit formation is there. Parthenocarpy. Parthenogenesis. Here genesis concerned with the embryo. Partheno without act of fertilization means here it is concerned with the embryo. And here parthenocarpy. Formation of fruit takes place without act of what? Fertilization. Parthenogenesis means formation of embryo takes place without act of fertilization in case of apomixis. And polyembryony, poly means many embryo, many embryo, concerned with many embryo. Formation of many embryo from nucellus or from diploid zygote, we call it as a polyembryony. See, this is the term parthenocarpy, carpel, this one fruit, formation of fruit, seedless fruit. Without act of fertilization, if fruit formation is there, we call it as a parthenocarpy. Without act of fertilization, if embryo formation is there, genesis, parthenogenesis. Polyembryo, many embryo, formation of many embryo from nucellus or from these are diploid zygote. In parthenocarpy carried out in case of banana, orange, grapes. Parthenogenesis, citrus, grasses, these are Poya bulbosa. And polyembryony carried out in case of these are citrus, mango, and these are maize, like this. Next, see, these are five terms. See here. Differentiated. Apomixis or a gamospermy. Seed formation without fertilization. Apomixis, seed formation. Automixis or autogamy, self pollination. Parthenocarpy, fruit formation without fertilization. Parthenogenesis, embryo formation without fertilization. And polyembryony, many. Poly means many. Many embryo formation, like this. So, dear student, this is all about that apomixis and that is very important.